berhari ini. Sesi PC hari ini berkenaan dengan soft launching harapan baru, policy talk. Just a brief overview. Sebab ini tahun baru, azam baru, harapan baru. Masa di mana pembangkang hanya membangkang dah pun tamat. Bagi sesi harapan baru dan policy talk, kita akan kendalikan setiap minggu, di mana Tun Dr. Mahdi Muhammad akan bincangkan tentang dasar-dasar dan jalan penyelesaian untuk menggerakkan Malaysia ke hadapan, dan juga mengimbas semula kejayaan-kejayaan yang dia berjaya lakukan sebelum ini, dan juga bagaimana kita nak aplikasikan kejayaan tersebut supaya kita boleh menggerakkan Malaysia ke haluan yang sebenar, haluan yang betul. So that's it for me. Let's hear from the man himself.
Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum and a very good morning to everyone. Firstly, selamat tahun baru. I hope we have a good tahun baru. For us, dalam Pakatan Harapan, tahun baru ini mempunyai makna yang lebih daripada tahun-tahun yang lepas, kerana pada tahun ini, jika Najib berani mengadakan pilihan raya, inilah tahunnya yang dia perlu ada pilihan raya. Dan kita di sini bukan berhajat untuk membantah, membangkang saja. Kita mempunyai plan untuk mengatasi masalah-masalah apabila kita mengambil alih kerajaan Malaysia. Kita tahu bahawa dahulu parti-parti pembangkang gagal untuk merebut kuasa. Sebabnya kerana mereka tidak bersatu, tidak dapat mengadakan satu gabungan, dan kalau diadakan pun tidak tegap, tidak really operational. Habis-habis baik ialah semasa mereka mengadakan Pakatan Rakyat. Tetapi kita tahu Pakatan Rakyat ini tidak dapat bertanding sebagai satu pakatan, satu coalition, kerana seperti biasa pemerintah tidak membenarkan mereka mempunyai satu logo, satu simbol untuk pilihan raya. Mereka bertanding mengikut dengan menggunakan simbol masing-masing. Namun demikian, Pakatan Rakyat berjaya mendapat sokongan majoriti penduduk Malaysia, 52%. Kali ini kita punya gabungan lebih kemas. For the first time, we have a proper coalition. Demikianlah kuatnya coalition ini sehingga dia menakutkan kerajaan. Kerajaan sedang berusaha sedaya upaya melalui cara-cara yang tidak halal untuk menghalang coalition ini daripada didaftar dan menggunakan logo ataupun simbol yang satu bagi Pakatan Harapan. Inilah cara kerajaan yang ada sekarang ini. Mereka menyalahgunakan kuasa apabila mereka berada dalam ketakutan. Namun demikian, kita mempunyai perancangan kita dan kita akan mengatasi segala masalah yang di merintangi perjuangan kita. Dan kita mempunyai bukan sahaja solution terhadap perkara-perkara yang memburukkan negara yang telah dilakukan oleh Najib, khususnya apa yang dilakukan dengan wang 1NDB, hutang yang tak dapat dibayar, hutang yang terlalu banyak sehingga akan melibatkan pembayaran berpuluh-puluh tahun, dan mungkin juga ada kalanya kita tak dapat bayar dan kita terdedah kepada kemungkinan menjadi muflis we can become bankrupt. We have a plan. Of course, we can't explain to you exactly what our plans are, but we have a plan how to deal with the problems created by Najib, including his selling bits and pieces of this country to other people. But beyond that, we know how to, we have plans on how to revive the economy, revive the strength of the ringgit, and also to go back towards rebuilding this country. As you know, Najib has launched TN50. TN50 is an admission that they have failed to complete the Wawasan 2020. But TN50 is a fair copy of Wawasan 2020. And the admission is that they need another 32 years before they can accomplish. But they're trying to divert attention daripada Wawasan 2020 kepada TN30, yang mana Najib tentu tahu dia tidak akan jadi Perdana Menteri pada masa ketika itu. Itulah sebabnya yang diletakkan TN ini 30 tahun daripada 30 tahun lebih daripada sekarang. Tetapi kita mempunyai cara-cara untuk menjayakan Wawasan 2020 mungkin terlewat sedikit kerana kita kehilangan hampir 9 tahun tidak ada usaha untuk melaksanakan plan kita for the 2020. But I don't want to go on too far because I think you may want to ask questions. You are welcome to ask any question. I'm not going to say no to your question. Even nasty question you can ask. And I'm sorry if I become equally not nasty in my reply. See, but you're welcome. Thank you. Ya, tahun ini tahun pilihan raya dan kita perlu update polisi kita mengikut perkembangan politik di dalam negara kita ini. Seperti mana kita tahu, tiap-tiap saat almost perkara bertukar, macam-macam perkara baru yang kita tidak sangka berlaku. Umpamanya mereka lancarkan apa nama imam pagi lancar petang patah. Ini menunjuk betapa apa nama tidak cekapnya, kerana ini dibincang dalam kabinet dan diperkenalkan kepada parlimen tetapi tak fikir mendalam, sebab itu mereka terpaksa batal. Baru-baru ini tentang Felda pula. Tanah Felda jelas dicuri, dijual tanpa diketahui dan kita tak tahu duit itu sampai kepada siapa. Every second almost, Najib is going to make a lot of mistakes and we are here to comment on those mistakes. That is why kita lancar harapan baru. This the new hope for the country. And believe me, we have a lot to contribute towards fulfilling the hope of the people of Malaysia.
So, what recently, Dr. Anwar, he handed in the application for the federal court to give back the white Yang Di-Pertuan Agong's power that in 1994 that had taken away the power. Is this one of the policies that you are talking about?
Yeah. We had not discussed this matter, but we want to know from him the reason why he wants to do that. And if it is something compatible dengan perjuangan Pakatan Harapan, we will adopt it. Sebenarnya tak ada halangan langsung. Semua yang nak dikehendaki telah kita beri. Dan apabila mereka kata ada masalah DAP, PPBM, bagi tahu apa dia masalah. Dan kita boleh betulkan. We stand to be corrected. Kita bukan nak menentang kerajaan. Kita nak supaya kerajaan berani mendaftarkan. Ini cara kotor. Tak berani lawan, lepas itu salah guna kuasa kerajaan. Dengan cara yang cukup unik. Bukan kata tak boleh didaftar, cuma tak jawab. Hantar surat reminder pun tak jawab. Jadi kita nak kata dia tolak pun tak boleh, dia lulus pun tak boleh kerana dia tak jawab. Tapi buat ucapan di sana sini, tak berani nak jawab. Inilah kerajaan bacul.
Is there any reason why you choose Wednesday? Is it because the government having a cabinet meeting Wednesday? So
not because of that, but you know where the cabinet meeting is held on Wednesday. It is in midweek. Midweek means people who have gone to some places would have come back, and they would not have left for the some holiday or other.
Okay.
Midweek is when everybody is in town. So it's the same with us.
Okay. You are the Pakatan Harapan's chairperson. I mean, organize the policy talk this way, are you unofficially declare your position as a future or prospective Prime Minister?
No, bukan soal Prime Minister. Soal saya chairman. Chairman ada kelonggaran sedikit untuk menjawab soalan-soalan dan mungkin mengisytiharkan sesuatu. We are in a position to answer question. Otherwise, why should I be the chairman if I can't even answer question?
And it is reported that three parties out of four parties, Pakatan Harapan, wanted you as to be the future Prime Minister. Is it okay with you, or do you foresee that?
I stand by the decision of all the four parties.
So, so far, do you expect any problem from PKR side?
I don't know because they haven't not told me anything.
Will your this decision be announced in the Pakatan Harapan convention on January 7th?
No, I cannot say because we have not decided. Maybe tomorrow is the 4th and we are having a meeting of Pakatan Harapan.
Okay.
Maybe if they want to, they can mention it then, whether they are going to announce or not. But tomorrow we'll know.
Do you think that the word interim Prime Minister is good for the Pakatan Harapan in getting support and confidence from the general voters?
I am 92 years old. This year I'll be 93. Obviously, I'm not going to be whatever Prime Minister or whatever until I'm 100 years old.
But should Pakatan Harapan use
interim
or?
That's up to them. We are a free group. We can use whatever words we want.
Tuan, adakah polisi talk ni Tuan nak mencari satu kata sepakat berkaitan dengan manifesto? Polisi talk ni. Salah satu ni cara untuk Tuan mencari muafakatan untuk memilih manifesto yang sesuai.
Kita telah buat draft manifesto dan kebanyakan yang saya sebut adalah dari draft itu. Tetapi draft itu belum diluluskan lagi kerana kita sedang kaji sama ada benda-benda yang patut di fine tune ataupun dibatal dan sebagainya. Kita nak dengar pendapat rakyat kerana manifesto ini untuk rakyat, bukan untuk Pakatan Harapan.
So ia akan dibincangkan dalam konstitok ni juga?
Boleh, kalau tanya saya boleh jawab, saya jawab. Tak boleh jawab, I raise my hand. Sorry.
Bermakna tidak bermakna policy talk ni akan bercakap pasal isu dalam manifesto tu sendiri, tapi dia ada satu isu lain yang akan di...
Semua boleh. Saya dah kata tadi, boleh tanya semua. Tentang apa nama mufti pun kena tanya-tanya lah.
Ucapan yang baru-baru ni dari GM adanya tu sikit restore the power of the judiciary. Jadi itu ada mengundang kritikan di sebelah sana. Mungkin kau boleh komen pasal kembalikan kehakiman.
Kehakiman? Yes. Ya, kita dapati kadang-kadang benda yang jelas tak betul dibuat keputusan. Jadi kita sangka mungkin ada pengaruh lain. Dan kita tak nak. Kita tahu bahawa dalam demokrasi mesti diasingkan kuasa antara legislatif, eksekutif dengan kehakiman. Kalau sekarang ni kita nampak yang jelas ialah legislative head boleh menguasai eksekutif untuk membuat perkara-perkara yang salah, clearly salah. Umpamanya pegawai tidak boleh sembunyi evidence. Kita dapati ada tiga buah laporan daripada Bank Negara, MACC, PAC. Dia ini disembunyi. Itu tak boleh sembunyi. The secrecy law is not about hiding evidence of crimes. It is about wrongful use of wrong policies which may not be necessary to announce to people. Like, we are going to establish relation with some country. Kita kena tunggu kemudian baru boleh kita release. Waktu ini dia secret lah. Tetapi ini jelas sekali laporan berkenaan dengan jenayah yang dilakukan oleh Datuk Sri Najib disembunyi di bawah Official Secrets Act. Ini salah. Official Secrets Act bukan untuk sembunyi evidence of crime. Jadi kita dapati bahawa AG nampak buat salah, benda yang salah. Tetapi dia salah guna kuasa pasal AG yang boleh bawa kes ke mahkamah. Okey. Okey. Are you ready?
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam sejahtera kepada rakan-rakan media sekalian. Terima kasih kerana sudi hadir bagi sesi PC pada hari ini. Sesi PC hari ini berkenaan dengan soft launching harapan baru, policy talk. Just a brief overview. Sebab ini tahun baru, azam baru, harapan baru. Masa di mana pembangkang hanya membangkang sudah pun tamat. Bagi sesi harapan baru dan policy talk, kita akan kendalikan setiap minggu di mana Tun Dr. Mahdi Muhammad akan bincangkan tentang dasar-dasar dan jalan penyelesaian untuk menggerakkan Malaysia ke hadapan dan juga mengimbas semula kejayaan-kejayaan yang dia berjaya lakukan sebelum ini dan juga bagaimana kita nak aplikasikan kejayaan tersebut supaya kita boleh menggerakkan Malaysia ke haluan yang sebenar, haluan yang betul. So that's it for me. Let's hear from the man himself.
Terima kasih. Assalamualaikum and a very good morning to everyone. Firstly, selamat tahun baru. I hope we have a good tahun baru. For us, dalam Pakatan Harapan, tahun baru ini mempunyai makna yang lebih daripada tahun-tahun yang lepas, kerana pada tahun ini jika Najib berani mengadakan pilihan raya, inilah tahunnya yang dia perlu ada pilihan raya. Dan kita di sini bukan berhajat untuk membantah, membangkang saja. Kita mempunyai plan untuk mengatasi masalah-masalah apabila kita mengambil alih kerajaan Malaysia. Kita tahu bahawa dahulu parti-parti pembangkang gagal untuk merebut kuasa. Sebabnya kerana mereka tidak bersatu, tidak dapat mengadakan satu gabungan, dan kalau diadakan pun tidak tegap, tidak really operational. Habis-habis baik ialah semasa mereka mengadakan Pakatan Rakyat. Tetapi kita tahu Pakatan Rakyat ini tidak dapat bertanding sebagai satu pakatan, satu coalition, kerana seperti biasa pemerintah tidak membenarkan mereka mempunyai satu logo, satu simbol untuk pilihan raya. Mereka bertanding mengikut dengan menggunakan simbol masing-masing. Namun demikian, Pakatan Rakyat berjaya mendapat sokongan majoriti penduduk Malaysia, 52%. Kali ini kita punya gabungan lebih kemas. For the first time we have a proper coalition. Demikianlah kuatnya coalition ini sehingga dia menakutkan kerajaan. Kerajaan sedang berusaha sedaya upaya melalui cara-cara yang tidak halal untuk menghalang coalition ini daripada didaftar dan menggunakan logo ataupun simbol yang satu bagi Pakatan Harapan. Inilah cara kerajaan yang ada sekarang ini. Mereka menyalahgunakan kuasa apabila mereka berada dalam ketakutan. Namun demikian, kita mempunyai perancangan kita dan kita akan mengatasi segala masalah yang di merintangi perjuangan kita. Dan kita mempunyai bukan sahaja solution terhadap perkara-perkara yang memburukkan negara yang telah dilakukan oleh Najib, khususnya apa yang dilakukan dengan wang 1NDB, hutang yang tak dapat dibayar, hutang yang terlalu banyak sehingga akan melibatkan pembayaran berpuluh-puluh tahun, dan mungkin juga ada kalanya kita tak dapat bayar dan kita terdedah kepada kemungkinan menjadi muflis. We can become bankrupt. We have a plan. Of course, we can't explain to you exactly what our plans are. But we have a plan how to deal with the problems created by Najib, including his selling bits and pieces of this country to other people. But beyond that, we know how to, we have plans on how to revive the economy, revive the strength of the ringgit, and also to go back towards rebuilding this country. As you know, Najib has launched TN50. TN50 is an admission that they have failed to complete the Wawasan 2020. But TN50 is a fair copy of Wawasan 2020, and the admission is that they need another 32 years before they can accomplish. But they're trying to divert attention daripada Wawasan 2020 kepada TN 30 yang mana Najib tentu tahu dia tidak akan jadi Perdana Menteri pada masa ketika itu. Itulah sebabnya yang diletakkan TN ini 30 tahun daripada 30 tahun lebih daripada sekarang. Tetapi kita mempunyai cara-cara untuk menjayakan wawasan 2020 mungkin terlewat sedikit kerana kita kehilangan hampir 9 tahun tidak ada usaha untuk melaksanakan plan kita for the 2020. But I don't want to go on too far because I think you may want to ask questions. You are welcome to ask any question. I'm not going to say no to your question, even nasty question you can ask. And I'm sorry if I become equally not nasty in my reply. See, but you're welcome. Thank you. Ya, tahun ini tahun pilihan raya dan kita perlu update polisi kita mengikut perkembangan politik di dalam negara kita ini. Seperti mana kita tahu, tiap-tiap saat almost perkara bertukar, macam-macam perkara baru yang kita tidak sangka berlaku. Umpamanya mereka lancarkan apa nama imam. Pagi lancar, petang patah. Ini menunjuk betapa apa nama tidak cekapnya. Kerana ini dibincang dalam kabinet dan diperkenalkan kepada parlimen. Tetapi tak fikir mendalam. Sebab itu mereka terpaksa batal. Baru-baru ini tentang Felda pula. Tanah Felda jelas dicuri, dijual tanpa diketahui dan kita tak tahu duit itu sampai kepada siapa. Every second almost Najib is going to make a lot of mistakes and we are here to comment on those mistakes. That is why kita lancar harapan baru. This the new hope for the country. And believe me, we have a lot to contribute towards fulfilling the hope of the people of Malaysia.
So, what recently, Shafri Anwar, he handed in the application for Cerebral Club to give back the point yang diputuskan Agong's power that in 1994 that had taken away the power. Is this one of the policies that you are talking about?
Yeah. We had not discussed this matter, but we want to know from him the reason why he wants to do that. And if it is something compatible dengan perjuangan Pakatan Harapan, we will adopt it. Sebenarnya tak ada halangan langsung. Semua yang nak dikendaki telah kita beri. Dan apabila mereka kata ada masalah DAP, PPBM, bagi tahu apa dia masalah. Dan kita boleh betulkan. We stand to be corrected. Kita bukan nak menentang kerajaan. Kita nak supaya kerajaan berani mendaftarkan. Ini cara kotor. Tak berani lawan, lepas itu salah guna kuasa kerajaan. Dengan cara yang cukup unik, bukan kata tak boleh didaftar, cuma tak jawab, hantar surat reminder pun tak jawab. Jadi kita nak kata dia tolak pun tak boleh, dia lulus pun tak boleh kerana dia tak jawab. Tapi buat ucapan di sana sini tak berani nak jawab. Inilah kerajaan bacul.
Is there any reason why you choose Wednesday? Is it because the government having a cabinet meeting Wednesday? So
and not because of that, but even where the cabinet meeting is held on Wednesday. it is in midweek. Midweek means people who have gone for to some places would have come back, and they would not have left for the some holiday or other.
Okay.
Midweek is when everybody is in town. So it's the same with us.
Okay. You are Pakatan Harapan's chair president. I mean, when you organize the policy talk this way, are you unofficially declare your position as a future or prospective prime minister?
No, bukan soal prime minister. Soal saya chairman. Chairman ada kelonggaran sedikit untuk menjawab soalan-soalan dan mungkin mengisytiharkan sesuatu. We are in a position to answer question. Otherwise, why should I be the chairman if I can't even answer question?
And it is reported that three parties out of four parties, Pakatan Harapan, wanted you as to be the future prime minister. Is it okay with you, or do you foresee
I stand,
that?
I stand by the decision of all the four parties.
So, so far, do you expect any problem from PKR side?
I don't know, because they haven't not told me anything.
Will your this decision be announced in the Pakatan Harapan convention on January 7th?
I cannot say because we have not decided. Maybe tomorrow is the 4th and we are having a meeting of Pakatan Harapan.
Okay.
Maybe if they want to, they can mention it then, whether they are going to announce or not. But tomorrow we'll know.
Do you think that the word interim prime minister is good for the Pakatan Harapan in getting support and confidence from the general voters?
I am 92 years old. This year I'll be 93. Obviously, I'm not going to be whatever prime minister or whatever until I'm 100 years old.
But should Pakatan Harapan use
interview
or?
That's up to them. We are a free group. We can use whatever words we want.
Okay, adakah Polisi Talk ni tu nak mencari satu kata sepakat berkaitan dengan manifesto? Polisi Talk ni. Salah satu ni cari cara untuk tu mencari mufakatan untuk memilih manifesto yang sesuai.
Kita telah buat draft manifesto dan kebanyakan yang saya sebut adalah dari draft itu. Tetapi draft itu belum diluluskan lagi kerana kita sedang kaji sama ada benda-benda yang patut di fine tune ataupun dibatal dan sebagainya. Kita nak dengar pendapat rakyat kerana manifesto ini untuk rakyat, bukan untuk Pakatan Harapan.
So ia akan dibincangkan dalam konstitok ni juga? Ataupun
boleh, kalau tanya saya boleh jawab, saya jawab. Tak boleh jawab, I raise my hand, sorry.
Bermakna polisi tok ni akan bercakap pasal isu dalam manifesto itu sendiri, tapi dia ada satu isu lain yang akan di...
Semua boleh. Saya dah kata tadi, boleh tanya semua. Tentang apa nama mufti pun kena tanya-tanya lah.
Ucapan Tun baru-baru ni dari GM Alimian tu sikit restore the power of judiciary. Jadi itu ada mengundang kritikan di sebelah sana. Mungkin Tun boleh komen pasal kembalikan kehakiman.
Yes. Ya, kita dapati kadang-kadang benda yang jelas tak betul dibuat keputusan. Jadi kita sangka mungkin ada pengaruh lain. Dan kita tak nak. Kita tahu bahawa dalam demokrasi mesti diasingkan kuasa antara legislatif, eksekutif dengan kehakiman. Kalau sekarang ni kita nampak yang jelas ialah legislative head boleh menguasai eksekutif untuk membuat perkara-perkara yang salah, clearly salah. Umpamanya pegawai tidak boleh sembunyi evidence. Kita dapati ada tiga buah laporan daripada Bank Negara, MACC, PAC, dia ini disembunyi. Itu tak boleh sembunyi. The secrecy law is not about hiding evidence of crimes. It is about wrongful use of wrong policies which may not be necessary to announce to people. Like, we are going to establish relation with some country. Kita kena tunggu kemudian baru boleh kita release. Waktu ini dia secret lah. Tetapi ini jelas sekali laporan berkenaan dengan jenayah yang dilakukan oleh Datuk Sri Najib disembunyi di bawah Official Secrets Act. Ini salah. Official Secrets Act bukan untuk sembunyi evidence of crime. Jadi kita dapati bahawa AG nampak buat salah, benda yang salah, tetapi dia salah guna kuasa pasal AG yang boleh bawa kes ke mahkamah.
Kita maafkan, berbalik pada soalan tadi. Dia ada kritik, antara kritikan itu adalah peristiwa pemecatan Tun Saleh Abbas. Jadi dia kritik Tun sebagai...
Tun Saleh Abbas was only not because of me. Unfortunately, in order to save good name of the Yang di-Pertuan Agong, the AG at that time, guna nama saya, kununya saya suruh. Saya tak ada campur tangan langsung. Kemudian baru saya tahu yang dia guna saya kunun suruh dia pecat. Saya tak suruh. Saya berani junjung Quran, masuk dalam masjid dan bersumpah bahawa saya tak suruh dia sebut bahawa saya yang suruh. Yang suruh, Yang di-Pertuan Agong. But now, of course, the letter has been hidden. Letter written by Saleh Abbas kepada Yang di-Pertuan Agong, complain pasal bising, dan letter itu juga dihantar kepada semua raja-raja. Dan Yang di-Pertuan Agong amat marah, amat murka, minta saya buang Saleh Abbas. Saya kata tak boleh buang pasal dia kalau nak buang kena ada tribunal. Agong kata apa? Ya, buat tribunal. So I was doing things that only the Agong can legitimize. Saya sendiri tak boleh buat.
What you say just now, you have letter, you said there was a letter sent to Tun Saleh Abbas. You have written...
Sent by Tun Saleh Abbas to the Agong.
Okay.
The letter complained because Saleh Abbas' house is near the Agong's private house, and they were doing some repairs to Agong's private house, making a lot of noise. And because of that, Tun Saleh Abbas wrote a letter to the Agong to ask him that they're making too much noise, to stop the noise. But that is improper. A senior officer must go and meet the Agong and make his request or whatever. But this, not only did he write to the Agong, but he actually sent copies of the letter to the other rulers.
Okay. Tun, I know that what you say, hold weight, but do you have any evidence to substantiate what you say? I mean, because you were blaming the king for that crisis. And do you have any...
This letter of Saleh Abbas had something written by the king on the side, and I took that to cabinet.
Okay.
Yeah. Eventually, when we decided to set up, I had to discuss with cabinet. Cabinet said we cannot do it unless we set up a tribunal. To set up the tribunal, I had to get the permission of the king, and after that, the letter was given to the officials. But today the letter cannot be found.
Okay. I mean, Tun, in many incidents, when people blame you, and then you came out and you came out and defended yourself with similar excuse, and I mean, or we look at that incident, including this judiciary crisis. Then why were you making apology on that day?
I made apology for all the mistakes that I may have made, or which people perceive that I have made. All the time I've been in politics.
But not in this incident?
It's up to them. They want to think it is about this incident, they can.
Memali
also, they can. They can. I didn't. I have my defense.
Okay.
But that does not mean that people will accept my defense.
And PNM Forex?
Oh. Yes, yeah. There they set up the RCI.
Okay, can you yourself give an example?
Would you believe if I tell you the truth? You won't believe. I know, especially the opposition at that time will not believe.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I was painted as a monster. Huh?
Okay.
And yet, I am now accepted by the people who painted me as a monster. Why do they accept me?
Okay. On the 4th January, Pakatan Harapan Presidential Council, what are the issues that will be discussed, including whether to announce a Prime Minister candidate?
Wow.
You?
I haven't seen the agenda, so I don't know.
But you would.
I will check. It.
Yes.
Yeah. Sometimes the agenda comes last minute.
And also, there was a report saying that the past ulama chief, Sheikh Al Hadi, Dato' Sri Hadi Amanat in 1981, was relevant because when the country ruled by you was anti-Islam at that time. What is your defense?
Yeah. The opposition always says nasty things about the government. And when the government replied, the opposition never accept. The people who abuse Islam is Hadi. Hadi, in his amanah, stated that the government is a kafir government, and that it is legitimate to fight, and if you die during the fighting, you go to heaven. That's what he was promising. And this is totally wrong, against the teachings of Islam. And yet, people who know the religion just kept quiet.
And Hadi pledged to contest 136 parliamentary seats.
Where? How many?
130.
This time?
Yeah, coming.
Yeah, Hadi knows very well most of the seats he's going to lose. But he will be helping Najib win by splitting the opposition vote. That is his intention. And that is not very Islamic. In Malay, we call that pengkhianat.
But why do you have to use such a serious word, pengkhianat?
Yeah, because that is what he is.
But isn't that...
I mean, he is going to go in and contest when he knows very well he is going to lose, but he knows the effect of his contest. Can you understand what I say?
Okay.
Are you here, nah? When you... Because he goes in and contests to split the opposition vote so that Najib will win. He himself will lose. He may win a few seats. You know, when PAS contested as PAS without joining any coalition, they never won more than 11 seats. There was once when they won only one seat on their own. They only won when they joined DAP. With DAP, they won 21 and then 27 seats. So now they are going to go in alone. And alone they are going to lose. Of the 130 or 1 million seats that they want to contest, they will lose all, but they will be helping their good friend, formerly the kafir from UMNO. Najib is a kafir, according to PAS. You see, and he is going to help this cafe, which he says that if you work with cafe, you become cafe. So now that he is working with UMNO, and at one time he worked with DAP, he is cafe-ing himself.
UMNO youth leader lodged a police report against you for instigating the people to topple Najib.
All over the world, people overthrow bad government. I'm not instigating anything. All I'm saying is that you have a bad government, overthrow it. It's democratic process. Even in an authoritarian country, people try to overthrow the government. Okay. But this stupid boy who doesn't understand politics report that I'm trying to overthrow the government. Of course I'm trying to overthrow. This is a kleptocratic government. You want it, this boy wants a kleptocrat because maybe he gets money from that.
In your speech, you mentioned about that there is a risk for the country to become mufliss.
Yeah.
Okay.
So you know how much the government owes now? It's $900 billion. Some long-term, some short-term loan. And to pay that, if you cannot pay, you know, if you don't borrow money from the bank, you don't pay, they make you bankrupt. So you see what happened to Greece, made a bankrupt country because it couldn't pay the loan. But here we have borrowed even more than Greece, and we are poorer than Greece.
Okay, can we get final question before we wrap it up?
Semalam ada ahli ketua bahagian terbelu, dia buat report ke RS, menyatakan bahawa AGM PBBM baru ni tidak sah kerana langgar perlembagaan. Jadi kita komen sikit. Disebabkan senarai
perwakilan yang wujud. Ya, tolong dia ni lah, kata kat Ross to buat official statement, kata syarat kita tak sah. Ross tak kata apa, tapi orang ini lebih pandai daripada Ross.
Disebabkan dia kata perwakilan tu tak wujud, disebabkan tiada mesyuarat diadakan di tingkat bahagian.
Yalah, itu Ross boleh tengok. Ada sebab-sebab.
Okey, itu saja. Terima kasih.
Okey. Habis dah?